You took some time off from being a lawyer in between?
Yes, I did.
What was that about?
I was going through divorce, and I had 4 daughters, and I needed to be close to home. And what I did is I took some time off, and I taught high school Spanish.
Wow, congratulations. I only have 3 daughters, I stopped there. So, you know, I've heard good about you and bad about you. I spoke to somebody in my office this morning about you, who you know, who's on the DIA review board, and said, you're wonderful. And you do smart things, and I think, Carol Pelletti. I've also read many constituents who called me just like they did the other counselors. And some of the things they said, and I just wrote them down, was that you prejudge cases, and that you don't listen to the evidence, you don't listen to them, you go in with your mind made up. And I'm just wondering, is there any explanation? You know, Attorney Henry said, like, you're over-prepared sometimes. And maybe sometimes the tact that you take of going in knowing what you know already, and maybe just asking pointed questions. I don't know. I'm just asking you, can you explain why people think that you can judge cases?
I don't know, because as I indicated to you, my practice is I don't make any decisions until after I get a lawyer. I wait till the conference. The only time you will see me write a decision, write an order, what I'm going to do is when the parties do an agreed order. Because the parties agree, that's great. I mean, we just do resolution, that's what you want. And if they decide they want to do that, I go with it. I work with the parties, I try to give the parties what they need to be able to work through their case. I can't explain what their perception is. I do, you know, lots of times I get a complicated case, and sometimes you don't get answers you need. I may ask a question, but I do not prejudge. I don't understand why they believe I do.
I should tell you the good with bad, because the person who wrote me this email, who's a good practitioner and been on several committees, some with you and some not with you, said you're very nice outside courtroom too.
Oh.
So I'm telling you that they're good. She wrote that she thought that you prejudge cases. Tell me about, and I should know this more, but tell me about the process that Attorney Colletti's on and how people go there. Do these witnesses show up in front of you and give input?
I don't know. We file the application, and then I know as a sitting judge, Rod Mathen gives the interview, and we go to, I'm not sure which panel's first. I believe one's a nominating counsel, and I don't remember who's on that. It's really who's comprised of it. I just read it on a turn. Then we go to an advisory council, which is the Workers' Comp Advisory Council, which, once again, I just can't remember who's who. There were a lot of people. They ask us questions. They have our stats. They know the practitioners. I don't know if people are invited. I don't know who knows. Who knows what?
Yeah, we follow Executive Order 456. And basically, yes, the nominating panel goes first.
It's a
cross-section of all stakeholders involved in workers' comp, the labor side, medical side, insurers, employee side. So it's a cross-section of 30.
Would that be the JMC?
It's kind of the equivalent of the JMC.
Yeah,
legal counsel on it, Secretary of the WD, so cross section. So there are no witnesses there. I know people can submit letters or what have you to the panel in itself, but there are no witnesses. It's a closed session, and we're not allowed to talk about what's said. It is kept confidential.
Are you there?
I am there, yes, along with the director of the DIA. A vote of 7 votes moves it forward to the advisory council. The advisory council gives an opinion. They cannot hold up a nominee. They simply give an advisory opinion. How qualified, no consensus. Right. Again, this is a cross section. It's the advisory council. Again, a cross section of all the participants under the workers' comp. That opinion is sent letter to the governor's office. At that point, I believe governor's legal counsel usually sits down with the nominee, or the candidate, interview, and do this also. At time, not always, interview with the lieutenant governor. At that point, he sends the governor and receives forward to this council. That's how the procedure works. There are no witnesses within any of those.
So, Yeah, no, no open opportunity.
There's no, no, it's, they are closed session, they have to go into executive session. And again, we're under, I can only speak to what is said, delivered.
All right, I appreciate that, thank you. Your peer rate, do you think it's higher than the average judge?
I don't know, I don't know how many decisions I've written, so I guess if you're looking at percentage, I mean, if I've got seven that go to return, how high, I don't know how many decisions I've written. I mean, if I've written 60 since my time there, seven will appeal, you're looking at a different number than if I wrote 20, a 30, I don't know.
Judge, do you have any stats on the appeal?
I could say it's not out of the ordinary, if people settle cases, maybe posture for settlement, after review decision, they review board, they listen to the possibility, they can reverse or amend it. So, is that really a question, on the word, remand, reverse, it could be, could narrow the, apply the error of law, it could be kind of baby, I see it that way. Anyway, but I wrote a few decisions. So with that, I don't think it, she's not, you know, outside, you know, she's trending in the forward, not at all. I think her decisions are fine, her stats are, again, keep on back.
Well, it's the first time I've ever got a call from labor unions. First time ever. I mean, I'm kind of a baby here. Definitely one of the first. I've been here 6 years. But I've never got calls by people, painters union, electrical union, saying, don't vote for her. She finds it against employees all the time.
That I can't believe that, counselor, because I, once
you can't believe I get the calls?
No, sir.
Because I can.
No, sir. I do order from you. I can't go back to each and every case, but it's not like they. I'm getting the perception that you feel that the minute an employee walks in, I've got a denial in my pocket. I really don't think that's accurate. I can't go back and pull every conference order, but I don't think that's the case. Because I don't think that's the case. I can't tell you what I decide in one particular case or not. I don't know what to tell you. I'm, you know, it's fact specific, but I don't think I'm going to quote unquote hanging judge. I'm sorry people have that perception. I think even Attorney McKenna said, yeah, she's fine with me on a lot. I don't know what to tell you.
I just wonder if there's an explanation. Listen, I've worked on both sides, employee and management. I get it. Some people need to, you know, be told that they can have benefits. And then, you know, I get it, but I mean, overall, I mean, the statutory scheme is that one of the key areas of work, right? But there are cases where people are faking it, and you've got to deal with it. I get it, you know.
It's once again, I look at everything, and I find it hard to believe that if someone believes I prejudge, I'm sorry, because I can tell you honestly that I don't. Clearly, I'm taking back every comment that I'm getting. And I'm clearly going to maybe not prepare so well. if people feel I'm in areas, if I don't know, I don't. I'll tell people all the time, look, you know, if you're having trouble settling, maybe go to mediation, because as things as the judge in the case, I can't say is a mediation another judge may be able to. I don't know what to tell you other than that I'm taking every single criticism back, every single comment. Which I will consider helpful suggestions, which I do. I can tell you, I can look in the mirror and tell you I don't prejudge. I don't know what the comment, I would never say the comment, so yes, I deny it. I don't know if someone was upset, I don't even remember the situation. I don't prejudge. I know what I do, sir. Yeah. It is not prejudging.
Oh, well, I find it troublesome.
Sure.
No, since you're in the middle of 7 years.
Yes.
And when this judge is on the case, I take 30% off the rest of the judge. Because it kills our client.
Sure.
Any explanation for that? Why is it moving?
I don't know. You know, I've been in practice, and even when I've had judges that I might have considered not the favorite type, whether it be in Superior Court, whether it be in District Court, whether it be in the Board, or even if I'm at NCAD, I've always tried that. I've always put in what I want, and I've never done that. But yes, there were judges I felt I wasn't happy with. And I'm sorry that's the perception, but I've also had other people tell me that the judge I'm the judge they want. So I can't explain it, sir.
Well, tell me how it works, because I don't know. I'm sure about my work is not to people that do know. But I was under the impression it was a 6-year window or something. Is that sound familiar? So would they get it over a 6-year period?
Oh, no.
For a lump sum settlement?
No. On the workers' comp, it depends. I mean, if you've got a 34 ed, the normal is usually 7 to 10 years, which is a permanent in total. It would depend on how strong the medical is. I mean, you've got a trained physician that returned the employee to work when they settle, and I'm only, when I look at settlements, I look at best interest of the employee. I don't do any negotiating. Counsel look and think what the chances are if the case has to go to hearing that a judge, you know, a judge would be or someone else can uphold finding 34 or 35. You know, I've had cases where I've voted 34A at conference. I've had cases where I've voted 34 and 35, where if I feel like I don't even have the benefits, I want to give the employee something. I'll vote a minimum, I'll do what I can. Do I issue denials? Denials, my assistant's with me. She knows I don't like to issue denials. I never issue denials. I don't even like to modify, especially at conference. I can't explain what was said to you, and when I made reference to the hearing transcripts, someone talked about a hearing, and then I made all these mistakes.
I'm just curious, when somebody says to us that, you know, we discount a case like 30% of rolling design, like how much impact do you actually have on the price of the settlement?
Clearly, if they're coming to conference before me, if they have a belief that I may go one other way, and based upon their evidence when they get to hearing, when they get to go on the record, they may feel that way. I don't know. I never know what I'm going to do at a conference. I put my pen down and I listen. The only thing I won't do is I won't take testimony from employees. I don't think that's appropriate. You know, sometimes if they ask if they can say something, even then the lawyer will say no. But let me do the talking. It's just the lawyers are talking about. Yeah.
Do other judges let the employees speak?
I can't speak to what other judges do. I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't. My
college.
Oh,
you practice a lot.
Oh, when I practice?
Yeah.
My experience when I practice, the judges who were sitting at the board do not let the employees speak. When I practiced, that was in, with Williamson and Lenders, that was in the, I guess, the 80s, of the 90s. I think I left there in the 90s, in 2000, and went up to electric. And I will see the probate court proceedings in Norfolk County coincide with my life.
All right. I've been there too. I have no further questions, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
So, when did you and the chief have a discussion about the issues that he brought up to you?
I don't remember as much of a discussion as when I got concerned about reappointment and I asked him what the
problem. My question, I want you to focus in on my questions. The chief just told us that he approached you at some point and you had a discussion about issues that he had heard about you. Did you hear him say that?
I did.
When did that take place approximately?
The ones I remember, I mean...
No, I'm talking about the one...
I don't remember, sir.
Did the chief have more than one discussion with you about your, what he had heard about your judging?
I believe so, but I never thought.
When?
I remember when I filled out my reappointment application.
When was that?
Oh gosh, it'd be the date of the application.
October of 2019?
That could be right.
Okay. So he had a discussion with you about that time.
But not to the level.
What did he say? The critique was, what was he saying to you?
I think he thought that they had something about, I remember the word arrogant going around.
Okay, so he mentioned something to you about he had heard that you were displaying arrogance in a courtroom. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. What else did he tell you that he had heard?
I don't remember because I don't remember to this level.
You know, let me, this is October of 2019.
Yes.
Hey, that's only what, 3 months ago, 4 months ago?
Yes.
If my boss came in to me and said, hey, Juvenile, I've heard you're arrogant, you're a pain in the ass, you're not doing cases right, you're quick with the lawyers, I would have remembered that. I find it hard to believe you don't remember what was talked about.
Well, no, I remember him making that comment that there might be a problem with reappointment because the perception was something that, I was arrogant. And yeah. I remember even making a concerted effort.
No. Okay. I don't want to hear about what you did. I want you to, you're a judge.
Yes, I don't.
Judges listen to questions and zero in on them. He said to you when you were applying, there's some issues with you, you may not get reappointed. There's some problems, right?
Yes.
So you, I would assume, was concerned about that.
Yes.
What problems, Judge? What problems, Chief? What are you talking about? Well, one thing is your area. What else did he say was a problem?
It was the way I appeared, my demeanor on the bench.
Okay.
And I remember after that being kind of taken back, and I didn't realize it was, I didn't think it was this level.
No. Okay. You're diverging. He said you were arrogant, he heard.
That was
the
perception.
Demeanor on the bench.
The perception, yes.
Perception of the demeanor. So that's a couple of things that are impeding or may stymie your reappointment, right?
Evidently, yes.
Well, that's what he said to you.
Yes, he said it may be a problem.
No. That's what he said to you, yes or no?
I believe that is accurate. Well, sir, you're asking for accuracy.
No. I'm asking for the conversation a chief on your reappointment had with you about problems you were having. And you're telling me, I don't really recall it. So we've got two things that he brought up to you. Arrogance and your demeanor on the bench. Did he bring anything else up to you that he had heard that may be a problem in your reappointment? Did he bring up the names of these two lawyers at all?
No, I never knew, and I never
asked. The answer is no, right?
No.
So did he bring up that he had heard anything else about you? Okay, just those two things and only those two things, right?
My recollection, I mean, I...
You know, I got to tell you, if I'm up for a reappointment and the chief calls me in for a good dressing down, I don't forget that.
It wasn't a dressing down.
Well, it was a criticism of you.
It was.
Right?
Yes.
How many times did he call you in and criticize you?
I don't think he was in criticism. I had gone down to him, I think maybe twice we spoke.
Did he call you down twice?
I think I went down to him.
And told him what?
I was asking about the reappointment process. I don't remember.
Did he tell you both times you got problems?
Yes.
And you were interested in knowing what they were?
I was.
What were they?
The arrogance and my demeanor.
What else?
I think there might have been a mention, I'm trying to recall, that maybe I was too tough. And I don't remember.
Okay, just let's take the too tough. Counselor Ryanella asked you that that's what he heard about you. And you said to him, never heard that before, didn't you?
No.
Didn't you tell Counselor Ryanella you had never heard that criticism before?
Yes.
Oh, but
in the bar.
Whoa. So, Counselor Ayanella said, I've heard you're too tough. And you said to the counselors and Chris Ayanella, I had never heard that before.
Sir.
Yes, okay, that you said yes. That was not true, was it?
Sir, you're twisting my words.
No, I'm not.
I'm uncomfortable, sir, with the way you're portraying this.
Okay,
and I would ask
let
me
do it slowly.
No,
I won't let you explain because you're not answering the question. You're going off on tangents. You're the judge, and you know you stick to the answer. Counselor Ayanella asked you, he said to you, I had heard you were too tough. In fact, he made a big point of it. You were too rigid. You were too tough. You said to him, what do you mean by rigid? And he said, well, you're too tough. And you said, I never heard of that. Did you or didn't you say that to him?
Yes, now I'm
okay.
Confused.
No. You're not confused. I'm asking you if that's what you said, and you said yes. Did you not?
I believe I did.
Okay. was not true, was it?
It
yes or no?
I don't know at this point.
Well, you just told us that the chief called you in October area and said the exact same thing to you.
Counsel Juvenal, I went down to Senior Judge Fernandez. I was not called in. Yeah. It was a conversation.
Let me tell you something. Stop with trying to divert. You were told by the chief, whether you went down to him or he went to you, you were told by the chief that he heard you were too tough in October.
I was told that it was my demeanor.
Wait, whoa.
Counselor, I'm
trying to remember. Answer my question. You told us, the chief told you, you were too tough, you were arrogant, and you had bad temperament. Did you just tell us that?
He didn't say bad temperament, Counselor. He said,
listen to me.
Okay, what you're doing, Counselor.
No, you're doing it. You told us, the chief told you, you were arrogant, you had a demeanor problem, and you were too tough. Didn't you tell us that's what was discussed?
That's what came up later as my recollection, as you prompted it along.
The answer is either yes or no.
Yes.
Okay. Chris Ionella asked you the same thing, and you said, I never heard of that.
When it was...
And you said yes.
Yes, can I explain?
Okay, so that was not true when you said to Chris Ionella, I had never heard about that being too tough before.
Upon recollection, when you asked me about when I had meetings with Senior Judge Fernandez, I told you, yes, I do remember going down to him on a reappointment, and I was concerned. He had told me that was an issue, and there could be problems with reappointment. When I was asked by Counselor Ionella, when it was being talked about, he was talking about lawyers from the bar talking about it. I had never heard anything from the bar.
Wait a minute here, please. He said that's what he heard about you. You were too tough, didn't he?
That's what he heard about you. That's what Counselor Ionella.
And that's what the chief said to you in October-ish. I hear you're too tough.
He said that was the perception.
So two people asked you that question, and today you said, I never heard.
Counsel, when you started talking about my discussions with Senior Judge Fernandez, I told you initially I didn't remember because it wasn't addressing down, sir. And as you went on,
you're diverting to different issues.
Okay.
So let's keep it simple.
Well, you're implying that I'm lying, Counselor. And I'm not lying. I'm trying to recollect what happened.
You're trying to say things here in a way that takes up time and diverts. You said to Chris Ionella, I never heard of anything criticism about me being too tough. You had heard that before from Chief Hernandez in the meeting you had with him at some time in October. One of the criticisms is you were too tough.
He said that was one of the perceptions, yes.
Right. Chris Ionella asked you said you never heard that.
Because when Counselor Ionella was talking about you, some of the phone calls he had, and I was referring to members of the bar. I have not heard that from any lawyers.
I don't care whether it's phone calls, members of the bar, or Chief Hernandez. They all said the same thing. They had heard you were too tough.
Okay, yes. Yes.
And you never heard about it before. Chris, I know. It's the first time I'm hearing about it, you said.
Yes, I said that, Counselor, but as you recollect, I was drawing my recollection of meetings with Judge Hernandez, and they weren't dressing down, sir. That's what I'm trying to explain to you. I don't know how else to explain it to you, sir.
I'm not going to let you just kind of go on and some stuff. So the first time you heard criticism from the chief was when you were going to be reappointed?
I remember talking to him about when...
I didn't ask you what you remember.
I believe that's correct. Yes, I believe that's correct, sir.
Okay. And you got three things that you remember he told you. Arrogance, temperament, and demeanor, and being too tough.
It was arrogance, demeanor, and being tough.
Too tough. So, when you went up for your reappointment with the process at the DIA, did you call any lawyers to send letters on your behalf?
I think can't remember, I know more letters were sent, I don't remember, I think I had asked maybe Attorney Henry for the letter.
Anybody else?
I remember Lori's asked me if they could, and I said, that's fine, whatever you want to do, but I did not want to put them in positions of appearing before me and having to write a letter. I said if they wanted to, they did. If letters went in, I don't know.
Well, did you get a copy of them?
No, I did not.
Did they tell you they sent letters in?
I don't, I learned about it at some point, I think.
We had another witness here that said he sent a letter in to you.
I don't remember getting a letter. I mean, if the letter was sent, it would have been sent.
When you went to the hearing, did anybody at the hearing say we got some letters from this person and that person that is supporting your position here?
At the nominating commission? Walked in from there, 10 people there, and I don't, they asked me questions about, you know, how life was on the bench, what I thought about it.
And those people that sent the letters, they didn't ask for your permission to send them?
People asked me if it was okay if they did, I said fine. I didn't want to put.
Who were the people?
Why not give names? God, I think it turned.
Why is it, was there something wrong?
No, I mean, Attorney Napolitano had asked me, Attorney Pierce had asked me.
People forget people, they call you.
I know, but there were a fair amount of them. I'll tell you this much, Attorney Lodge and Attorney Kennedy didn't ask me.
Well, from what they testified to, I guess I don't want them.
I guess not. I'm.
All right, so you went to the hearing and you got through it, right?
Yes, sir.
And you told us here today that you said the person I know first. You know, I'm going to reflect on what happened here today. I'm going to take it to heart. I'm going to make some changes. You recall that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. But on the other hand, you say you have no memory of anything these two lawyers said. You don't have any memory of acting inappropriately. So if what they say is a lot of bunk and it's not true, why would you change?
Because Counsel Dubinville, obviously if there's that many people saying that, it's something they're not comfortable with me doing. So even after I talk to Judge Hernandez, I'm going to ask for listening because I think I deserve that right. I've worked hard.
You deserve your right for what?
To be heard on this. After I talked to Judge Hernandez, I made a concerted effort to be to the point that when I walk out there, I make sure I say good morning to everybody. I'm to the point that, you know, normally when if people have me sit here for an hour and they call me, I make every effort to make sure I'm even out there quicker. I you know, and as far as you want to say that my word against Attorney Lodge and Attorney McKenna, what I'm telling you is I deny that statement. I don't remember what was said 3 years ago.
Well, you said a couple of things about that statement. You said, I think about, by my recollection, 5 times you said, I don't recall making
it.
No.
Yes, I did say that?
Okay.
I don't know.
Let me just say
discuss.
This to you about not recalling. I think I said it earlier. If you don't recall it, then it could have been said, right?
No, sir, I disagree with that assessment.
Well, there's only 2 options when you say on the stand or you're at a hearing like this, and I don't recall making that statement. It either happened and you forgot it, or you never made it, and you should be saying, I never made it.
I would never make a statement like that. That is not only inappropriate, it's stupid.
Then I guess my trouble with it is you kept saying, I don't recall.
Because, Counselor, I don't know what was discussed. I don't remember the case. I don't know. I also heard someone say the way something was said and how they interpreted. I don't remember what was discussed. Maybe they've interpreted the way they want to, but I did not. I would not make a statement like that. So if something was discussed.
Well, an interpretation, I don't care how you swing it, about on denying or cutting the brakes on some fellow. Oh, look, his wife's pregnant.
No, that I do not.
I guess he can't be that. What did he say? He can't work. I guess he can work.
I would never take.
Do you think that a lawyer would come before us and out of whole cloth make that statement up?
I don't know, sir. I don't know. I that's obviously going to be a
question. If he did, he should be disbarred.
I
should be removed as a lawyer because that is an awful, awful thing to make up out of whole cloth. Do you agree with me?
Yes, I do, sir.
I don't know these two lawyers that well. But from everything I hear, including from your witnesses, they're very nice, competent
lawyers. Yes, very good lawyers, very competent.
So tell me, why do you think somebody would make a statement, one of these fellows would make that statement here today? Or what would he get out of it?
I don't know, sir. I have no idea. Or why someone would sit here and defend an accusation like that, sir. I don't know. I can't explain.
Well, I got 9 calls. I don't even do this. I got 9 calls. 9. As the counsel earlier pointed out, I haven't gotten any on the other three. Not 1 call.
I don't understand, sir.
Every counselor got these calls. Now there's 2 fellows from the bar, well respected, according to everybody testifying. Do you think that this is some sort of a concerted effort by a group of people so you don't get reappointed?
Yes, sir, I don't know. I can't explain it.
If you were me sitting here, first of all, are you bored sitting here, or are you troubled that I'm asking you? Because if you're bored, I'll stop.
No, sir, I'm not. I am not.
Because 5 years ago or 6 years ago, when I voted for you, you sat in that chair and you told me that you would be an employee judge. They were going to get their due. It's one of the reasons I voted for you. I now hear something different from a whole slew of lawyers, that you're not that way. That if it's close, you never give it to the employee.
Sir, all I can say is if you go back and look at the comments, because that's not how I think it goes. I can't explain.
Let me ask you, what did you do to prepare to come here today?
I wasn't aware there were going to be witnesses.
Wait a minute.
Okay, what I do?
Let me just ask you. Until today, you never heard any criticism was going to be made to you by anybody at this point?
I heard there was going to be problems. I think I was advised.
Who told you there was going to be problems?
An attorney named Ann Clark.
Okay, and when did Ann Clark come?
At one of the hearings at the board, and then I got to the board.
You mean?
It could have been the advisory board, which board she's on.
Yeah, but that was, you heard those things about going to that. I'm talking about coming here.
I think when I spoke to Ms. Green, we spoke on January 8th to find the governor for my application. I don't recall if the 8th she told me that, or if it was when I returned from my vacation on the 13th I came back. It might have been the 13th.
December?
January, sir. This was
2 days ago?
Yes, sir. I had a pre-planned vacation, so I was going to make a move on that. I actually, when I spoke to Councilman Benny, she had said that usually people come in. I don't remember her. But she said that most people just don't come in without anybody. So I had asked Attorney Henry.
No, that's not what my question was. The question was, when did you first hear there would be some people coming to this council in opposition to your judge?
Me actually testify.
Or we're going to send letters or make calls or anything else? Before you went on vacation?
I'm not sure. I'm not sure. I'm inclined to think it might have been. I just don't remember the time. I did not know about witnesses coming to testify today.
You had no idea today there was going to be anybody testifying against you?
No, that's not true. I Miss Green had told me that there was possibly witnesses coming.
When did she tell you?
I think it was when I got back and I talked to her on that Monday the 13th, because I got back.
Today is the 15th.
Yes, sir. I was, the 8th was when my nomination got sent forward. I was away on vacation. We came back on the 11th.
Nobody called you on vacation and said, hey, we had issues?
No. I didn't hear from anybody on the 8th.
So on the 13th, when you got back, you heard the first time that there may be some people coming here.
Right, and that sometimes they show up, but sometimes they don't.
Right. What did you do about that when you got that call?
Well, I tried to find out who the witnesses were. I wasn't really told.
How did you do that?
I asked people.
Who? Basically.
I know. I think I might have even asked Ms. Green. I'm not sure. I don't think I talked to Judge Hernandez about it. I didn't see him today. I don't know who else.
Did you call anybody to say, hey, can you show up on my behalf?
I called Attorney Henry.
What did you say to Attorney Henry?
I just said, look, I think I'm going to be the character witness because I'm going up for reappointment. I wasn't familiar with the process of the appointment versus appointment. And I came up with an appointment I brought witnesses. And they said, you know, if you're around, would you want to come?
Did you tell Attorney Henry that there were some people going to come in against me?
I don't believe I did.
Yeah. Never brought that up to Attorney Henry?
No, because I asked him last minute.
Yes or no?
No, sir. Okay. I don't believe I did.
Did you call anybody else when you got back from vacation on Monday and say, can you show up at the council?
Well, I have a friend of mine, but she's on my public list because of her friends, Attorney Lori Harling, who's away.
Okay.
And they said, look, I'm at a loss.
You called her?
Yes, because...
what did you say to her?
I said, look, I think it might be a problem for reappointment. I don't know what I'm going to need. I don't know what's happening.
And did you ask her?
No, sir. She's on my public list. I did not ask her.
So you called her. That would have been Monday.
And she might have made phone calls. She said to me, look, I'll call some people.
Okay. And did she call you back?
She did. She said it was last minute. People weren't able to meet at 1:30 on a Wednesday.
Okay. Did she say anybody was coming in? Did people get over there?
No, she did not.
So, other than Attorney Henry, you never talked to anybody other than this lady who tried to get somebody about coming in?
Well, Attorney Napolitano asked me if there was anything he could do.
When did he ask you that?
Monday the 13th. And I said, look,
what time did you get back from vacation?
Oh, I was at work in the morning.
Okay. So he called you out
no,
of the
he was in. He was in the board. He was at the board.
And we, what, he came in your lobby?
No, he was in my courtroom. I was sitting in my courtroom.
Yeah.
And he asked if there was anything you could do. And I said, truthfully, I don't know what I'm going to do. And I said,
did you tell him that you may have some people coming in against you?
I don't know if I told him that. No, I don't believe I told him that because I wasn't sure. And
well,
I don't,
you told the other lady that you
was,
might need some help because you had heard there'd be some opposition.
But I talked to her like the night of the 13th, and when I talked to Ms. Green, it was like, I believe it was in the morning.
So, how did you tell the attorney that day in court?
It was in the morning. I was on the bench. I just said, I'm not sure what I'm going to need. I don't want to put you in a difficult position because you're here for me. I said, but any help would be greatly appreciated.
And what did you mean by help?
If they wanted to come up and give their opinion.
And then was that, did he say he would?
He's here.
No, I'm asking you, did he say he would?
He said he would try to show up.
Okay.
You talked to me.
No, excuse me. Please.
I just want to put that in.
No,
she talked to me. It's not being mentioned.
But you never said any more witnesses.
All right. I'm asking you.
Sure, sir.
So, he said to you that he would come here.
He said he would try to be here, yes.
Oh, okay. He had also written a letter for you back in October.
I don't really know everybody who wrote a letter. He said he did. He said he wrote one.
You didn't know anything about it till today?
I know letters were written, no one ever gave me the letters.
So he said he tried to be here. Did you say anything to him that there might be a problem or I might be having a problem?
I just said I didn't know. No. I said I didn't know what was expected. Any help would be appreciated because I talked to Judge Mendez.
No, my question is.
I don't remember. I don't believe I did.
You don't believe you said, well, if I have a problem, I need somebody to come.
I don't believe I did. He approached me, sir.
When you say you don't believe you did, that leads me to believe you're not sure.
That I was going to have a problem?
Yeah.
Well, I...
You know about the problem.
I knew the perception, but I didn't know I was going to have people testify against it. I didn't know the proportion of the problem. I didn't realize that counsel felt that strongly against me. These two lawyers were picked from
Yeah, I know, but what I'm getting at is you had the conversation with him and he said he tried to make it here for you.
Yes, sir.
And you didn't tell him you wanted him to testify.
I said anything you could do. I didn't use words testify. Anything you could do would help.
What did he say to you?
He said, I'll try to make it.
That's it?
Yes, sir.
Never discussed anything about it. I might need you.
I just said I don't know what's happening. I've heard that.
When you say I don't know what's happening, you know, you knew what was going to happen here. You were going to come and be interviewed for your reappointment,
mm-hmm.
right? You come here 7 years ago or 6 years ago, and you sat in the chair as a nominee and you were asked questions.
Yes, sir.
So you knew the process of. Right?
Yes, sir, but what I wasn't sure of whether it was reappointment versus appointment, I didn't know if they'd want that same level where I had already had a record at the board. I'm coming in as new the first time.
Okay. Now well, after the attorney had a conversation with him, he said, do anything. Who else did you speak to that day, Monday, about the hearing here?
Actually left me a message. He had and I was talking about and I saw this phone number and I heard it.
So you spoke to
the cafe in Watertown.
You spoke to Councilor Dane.
I did, sir.
Who was that?
It was Monday morning. She said she was waiting for me someplace in Watertown. I never got.
No. Please. Councilor Devaney called you and asked to meet with you.
No, sir, I never got the call. I was in Florida at that first.
On Monday, you were in court.
Yes, sir.
You had some conversations about people coming. You spoke to Councilor Devaney.
On the phone, yes.
And what was said on the phone?
I received a voicemail. She had indicated she was waiting for me.
What was said on the phone call?
I apologize that I never bought the message.
Okay.
I use all myself. I have my cell phone. I have this of all calls that came in.
Let's move on from the apology. Okay. What else was said?
I said that had I known that I would have been there. I asked her, I remember something about whether or not I should bring witnesses, and she said most people come up. At least the character witnesses, at least one. That's when I called Attorney Henry saying, wow, I should bring in a character witness. And I expressed one because I didn't know that I had to sit down and have breakfast with her because the time was so short.
What else was discussed on the phone conversation?
She had indicated to me that she was a little bit upset with the scheduling, that it was so quick, that it was late, and she had trouble getting my phone number from somebody. And I believe she said she had spoken to my husband. My husband was here with at home. I believe he gave me the cell phone number. Because my husband
was there any discussion about any issues at the council?
No, I don't think there was.
I'm asking you. So there was no discussion about any issues that might be popping up at the council?
No. Sorry, I don't.
She didn't say to you anything about receiving any phone calls.
no, sir, I don't believe the word was mentioned, because the phone calls we discussed for the appointment. I was on my cell phone in the office, I was due back on the bench. I don't believe there was.
Okay. Who else did you speak to after the phone call with the Council debating that day about this hearing?
I think I spoke to Ms. Green. It was Monday, I don't recall what time, it was probably 1 in the afternoon.
Did you speak to
him? I'm sorry.
Not for her?
No.
Okay.
Yes. Yes, I made my phone calls to the other
council. Was there any conversation that with Chair, the council, about any issues coming up here? Lauren.
Oh, Lauren. Yeah, she said that there may be some witnesses
coming in.
Yes, she was.
That's on Monday.
Yes.
Okay. You were at the court.
So it was Tuesday. She said it was Tuesday. Tuesday.
I'm on Monday.
Yes, sir.
Got off the phone call with the baby. Who else did you speak to on Monday about your hearing, your report?
I called a bunch of counselors. I think I got Counselor Pereira that night. He told me just about vacation. I got in touch with Counselor Dove. I spoke with Counselor Ianella Monday. I had spoken with I did.
Anything brought up about any problems at the council coming up?
No,